Welcome to another classification series episode of Biologic Official. In this vlog, I am going to explain the characteristics and classification of the phylum Annelida. The term Annelida came from the word annulus, which means ring. So the phylum Annelida deals with the ringworms. General characteristics of the phylum Annelida. First characteristics, the body is bilaterally symmetrical. Annelids have got three body layers, ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. That is why they are triploblastic. And they are true coelomate. True coelomate means their body layer arrangement is like this. This is ectoderm, outer layer. This is inner layer, endoderm. And this red one, mesoderm. And this is also mesoderm. So there are two mesodermic layers in case of true coelomate. And this is coelom. Coelom is totally bound by the mesodermic layers. Third character, their body is elongated, tubular, and divided into several repeating segments called metameres, and the phenomenon is called metamerism, which is only found in case of annelids. The first mouth-bearing segment is called prostomium, and the last one, that is anus-bearing segment, is called pygidium. They possess hydroskeleton, which helps in their locomotion. Their excretory organ, nephridia, and their locomotory organ consists of parapodia or setae. The larval forms of annelids is known as trochophore larva. Next classification, phylum Annelida consists of three classes, Polychaeta, Oligochaeta, and Hirudinea. Annelids are classified depending on the locomotory organ. In case of Polychaeta, parapodia and setae both are present. In case of Oligochaeta, only setae are present, but there is no parapodia. And in case of Hirudinea, there is no parapodia and no setae. They locomote using their muscular activity of their body. The class Polychaeta includes almost 63% of the whole phylum. Most of them are marine. The examples include Sabella, Neris, Aphrodita or sea mouse. In case of class Oligochaeta, the segmentation is both external as well as internal. They possess growing number of body segments, and the examples include earthworms like Lumbricus, Ferritima posthuma, etc. and Tubifex. In case of Hirudinea, the segmentation is external only. That means there is no internal septa. They have fixed number of body segments, and the examples include leeches like Hirudo, Hirudinaria, Placobdella, Acanthobdella, Macrobdella. If you have any queries, you may leave a comment below. And thank you for watching.